Hey guys, this is Comic Uno, and today I'm doing a review for Arrow. So let's start talking about this episode. With this episode, we get to see kind of the return of Diggle, because Oliver goes on this side mission to help Diggle and reassure Diggle that he does not need to be in jail because of the events that happened last season with his brother, and he's able to save Diggle. Now he's in a hideout with his wife. Now the rest of the team has to, or the new recruits, have to go against Church without Oliver. Now this is the big story of the episode, and they don't do a great job. Mr. Terrific gets stabbed in the back. He's okay in the end. But Wild Dog gets kidnapped by Church. And that's pretty much the whole episode. What did I think? Honestly, I was really bored with this episode. I just feel like not a lot happened that was interesting. I expected this episode to be more Diggle-centric, which it kind of was and kind of wasn't. It was definitely more Oliver-centric of trying to find Diggle. And there was, like, the one nice moment with Diggle having to convince himself to get out of jail because he does feel guilty, and I thought that was a good story continuing from last season to this season, but not strong enough for a whole entire episode. And the actual mission was kind of boring to me because it is really repetitive of Oliver, I don't trust my team. I trust my team. Cool team. And then I think that the reason why I haven't been liking this season so much is the new recruits. I just have not felt invested, and this whole episode is really relying on you feeling invested in these characters. Now the problem is that we don't really know these characters very well. The only character I feel invested in is obviously Mr. Terrific, because we knew Curtis from last season. I feel like he's the strongest character out of all of them. Ragdoll, whatever his name is, they have somewhat of a story with him and Felicity in this episode where they forgive each other, but I never really liked that subplot with Felicity last season, so to continue it here and try to make it fleshed out for Ragdoll, it didn't really work. And then we have Wild Dog, who is kidnapped. You should care about that, but he's also a character that we don't really have a lot of background on, and has just kind of been kind of two-dimensional to me. Like, he's had a lot of lines, but I haven't felt attached to Wild Dog. And I think the weakest character out of all of them, the character I was most excited for, is Artemis, who hardly has anything to do in this show. She just kind of says, oh, cool, I shot a bow and arrow. Awesome. Now I'll wait until I have another line next episode. She just does not have a lot of dimensions to her character. And again, that's the biggest problem of this whole season, is these new recruits being so relied on for the story and just not having a lot. I just don't feel like they have a lot to say, and it feels crowded. And I know that's been a problem with Arrow in the past, that there's too many people on the team, but now I think the problem is that there's too many people on the team we don't care about. So at least when there was Laurel and Roy and Thea and Diggle, it was a big team, but we saw those characters grow since episode one, really. And, it took them a long time to get into those suits. So now with these characters who we hardly know and get into these suits really quickly, it just, I find myself very bored watching the episodes, especially here where it wasn't very plot-driven, which is okay. I'm okay with episodes not being very plot-driven, but you have to rely on your characters then, and your characters felt really flat in this episode. Of course, Thea being my favorite character, having nothing to do, also made me pretty bored in this episode, but it's a shame because I felt like there were so many moments where they could have played the legacy card, especially with these new recruits and saying, hey, especially with Thea, even Diggle, because Oliver could have said something with Diggle and say, oh yeah, I'm trying to save someone who was actually in your place. And then Thea actually going into the hangout and saying, oh, hi guys, and just leaving for no reason. I'm like, why was she even in this scene? You're actually searching for scenes to put her in. Because you have nothing to say with her character. So what's the point of moving her into this mayor position, or helping the mayor position, if she doesn't really have anything to do there? At least as Speedy, she had a lot to do. She's always in the story. So, but I will say I like the little moment between Quentin and Thea. I've enjoyed their relationship, even though it's so sidelined in this episode and many episodes. I feel like this could have been the episode where they really brought in more Quentin and Thea, but there's so little time they really even try to do their story, where I actually think their story is the most interesting. The mayor aspect is very interesting, that it looks like next episode they'll do a little bit more with Church, which is another aspect I didn't like about this episode, and I guess the season overall, is Church as a villain. He's just so cartoonish, and he doesn't feel like a Damien Dark or Ra's al Ghul. Like, I keep thinking he's just a one-shot villain, but he just keeps coming back. I'm like, oh my god, he's still here, causing havoc for our team. I just want him to pass by already. But yeah, so as you can see, I wasn't very happy with this episode. I was very disappointed, and I hope next episode will be better. It looks like there's some more interesting plot things going on with the mayor stuff, so that should be cool, but we'll see. I was, again, very bored with this episode, but let me know in the comments below what you thought. So this is Comic Uno. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter. Don't forget to like my Facebook page. Also, description below, there are links for my comic book, Like Father, Like Daughter, and don't forget to like the Facebook page of Like Father, Like Daughter. I'll see you guys later. Bye.